Hi everyone, let's install some mods to make Minecraft into a really amazing VR experience. I know I said I would make this video a while ago and I kind of went radio silent and I am very sorry for that. It turns out that to upload a mod pack to CurseForge, you have to use specific words and you can't say specific words in the description and in the title. So it took me 5 rejections to get my mod pack uploaded. And that is why it's taken me so long to make this video. I am very sorry it's taken so long, but here we are, we're gonna do this now. We're gonna make Minecraft into a really cool VR experience that you guys can follow along and figure out how to do it. So, there are 2 ways in which you can do this. First is using CurseForge, which I would recommend. It is very easy from what I've seen. Or you could do it the second way, which is the way that I did it, and that is installing them all manually. We're gonna go through the CurseForge, then the manual way, and that's basically it. Now, there are 2 things that I should say before we start this video. First one is I haven't included all of the mods that were in the videos that I've showcased. The first one I haven't included is Fresh Animations, which I know it's a resource pack, but to get it to work with Fabric, there is a mod portion of it. So that's why I called it a mod in my video, but that hasn't been included because it's not on CurseForge's website, therefore it's not allowed to be included in the mod pack. So that's why we're going to have to talk about that after the fact, and I'm going to show you how to install it manually. And then the second thing I want to talk about is my specs. A lot of you guys asked me for my specs. So my PC had a 3080 Ti in it, and it has a 5950X, and I have 32 gigabytes of RAM. That was the specs I had when I made my videos, and in-game, during the day, I'd get about 50 to 60 FPS, and I'd get maybe 45 in certain situations if it got if the performance went down, and at nighttime and in caves I get around 80 to 100 FPS. So before some of you click off this video because you think your computer isn't good enough or isn't that high spec, basically the shader packs took up most of that. When I took off the shader packs, my FPS shot up. So basically what I would advise you to do is install the mods, don't install any shader packs, and try it, because you know, you might actually get decent FPS if you don't have the shader packs installed. And that's basically it. Without further ado, let's move on and do the first bit of this tutorial, which is installing it via CurseForge. So, here we are on CurseForge. Here is my mod pack. It is Ryan Clifford's VR Experience 1! Perfect. And there are some extra mods in here, actually, that I didn't include in any of the videos. They should improve performance, hopefully for you guys, and there's also dynamic lights, which some of you suggested. So there's a couple of extra mods in there that should help out with performance, and this will be linked in the description. All of the links from this video will be in chronological order of how I've mentioned them in the video. So just so you know, you can follow along very easily by following along in the description. So install via the CurseForge app. That's easy. You just click it. It should download it and install it. If you decide to download it manually, click the download button, then go to CurseForge. Go to your mod packs, click create custom profile, import, click on the mod pack, click OK, it installs. Easy as that. Pretty simple. I wish I had known about this when I made my video for the first time, because now I've installed everything manually and it's long. But hey-o, that's the way it goes. Let's talk about how to install it manually if that's the route you want to go down. First things first is you're going to want to install Fabric. So what you're going to want to do is go to your downloads folder, wherever you downloaded the Fabric installer. So I've got one here, double click it. Now, the version of Minecraft you want to install is 1.19.2. This little window will pop up. And the loader version is 0.14.13. That's the version that I know works. It's the version that I use. So I don't know if any of the newer versions work, but just click that, click install. You'll have installed Fabric. Congratulations. Now, let's move on to installing the actual mods. So like I said, all of the mods will be included in the description, so go there and look, and the version types will be in the description as well. Make sure you download the right version type. If you don't like download the right version type, it might not work. So once you've downloaded all of the mods, what I would do is, and they're all in your downloads folder, click the Windows button and then press R. You'll get this little run menu popping up. Type in percentage app data percentage, click OK. It takes you to this folder, and there will be a .minecraft folder. Double click that. If you've installed Fabric correctly, there'll be a .fabric here, which, you know, that's great. But we're not interested in that right now. We are interested in the mods folder, and we're going to be interested in the resource pack folder later when we install Fresh Animations. But for now, you just want to go into the mods folder, take the mods from your downloads folder, and put them in here. Now, what I would advise you do is install them in the order that I installed them in. because you don't want to just click and drag 25 mods and then try and play the game, because if an error comes up, you're going to have no idea which mod is causing the error. So I'd install them in the same order that I installed them in, because that's the way that I know it worked. And in my first video, I installed Vivecraft, VR API, Sodium, Iris, Architecture, Fabric API, Minecraft Physics Mod, which we're going to talk about later, and Immersion MC. Those are the mods that I installed first, so I'd install them first, put them in the mods folder, play the game, see if they're all working, make sure they're working, and then you can install the rest of the mods afterwards. And I'd install them two or three at a time if you want to be safe. If you want to be a madman and just install them all, you can just click and drag, but there's a chance they might not work, and then you'll have no idea which one is causing the issue. And that's basically that. You've installed the mods now. Congratulations, you've installed them manually. So let's talk about the fresh animations. There are two things you have to download, which again, links will be in the description. So we've got CEM, which you might notice if you've downloaded the mod pack was already included. I'm not sure if that's the correct one, so you might want to delete that one and replace it with this one. And then there's the fresh animations resource pack. So how do you find where your mods are installed using CurseForge? You go back to your CurseForge app, right click on the mod pack, click open folder. Opens up this, you've got your mods, and you've got your resource pack. So simply download those, go to your mods, get rid of this CEM if you want to play it safe. If you want to try putting the resource pack in and playing it, then that's fine. But I would just delete this and replace it with the CEM that from this website. And then obviously the resource pack, which is the FA version 1.7, that file goes into your resource pack mod, into this one. And then obviously, if you're doing it manually, same thing, .minecraft mod, the CEM goes in there, and the resource pack, fresh animations, goes in there. And that's it. You've installed all the mods. There's one more thing you have to do to get fresh animations to work in game. So what you're going to want to do is turn on the game, and I will see you guys in there, and I'll show you what you have to do. Okay, so you're in VR. You're in Minecraft. You've loaded up the game. It should say Minecraft version 1.19.2 Fabric, and it should say 90... Something like that, 97 mods or whatever it is. You might not have the physics mod installed, but we're going to talk about that in a minute. So what you're going to want to do is to go to options. You're going to want to go to resource packs. So as you can see, there's a few things in here. You basically want to press the arrow button to get them to go over to your selected mods. And that the main thing we want to do is the fresh animations here. As you can see, we've got the version here, which is 1.7 add S8. And it says in the thing to make sure that it's on the top, because as you can see, you can click an arrow here and it moves it. For some reason, they say make sure it's at the top. I've had it below and it's worked fine, but someone said to make sure it's at the top, so you can just do that. And you might have some of these other ones, illuminations, the eating animation, whatever it is, just put them all into this right hand side, click done, and it'll like reload and you should be good to go. You can load up a game and all of your things should be there, and that's it. Congratulations, you've now got the exact same experience that I have in VR. So congratulations. There is one more thing that I want to show you that could improve performance. So let's just go back out of VR and let's go talk about it. So there's one more thing that you can do that might improve your performance. I'm running the Minecraft launcher on Microsoft. I'm not sure if it's the same. As you can see here, I'm not sure if it is the same. But anyways, we've got the Fabric loader here, okay? What you want to do is go to installations, click on your Fabric loader, click the three dots, and click edit. And then go to more options, and as you can see here, it says XMX8G. You can see that there. Basically, what this is it's telling your computer how much RAM you can allocate to Minecraft. Now, I read online that the most you should do is 8G, because it can mess with Minecraft if you do any more than that. I don't know if that's true, but I think by default, it's set to 2G. So if you have, like, 32 gigabytes, it's only allocating 2 gigabytes of RAM to Minecraft, which obviously is not great. So what you want to do is look at how much RAM you have, and look at how much RAM is being used while you play Minecraft in VR. And if you have some leeway, you can add more RAM to Minecraft. So for me, there was loads. I had like 15 gigabytes of RAM left over while playing VR Minecraft. So that meant that I could put it to the max of 8G. But let's say you have 8 gigs total, And when you're playing Minecraft VR, maybe it's at 5 gigabytes RAM being used. So that means you've got 3 gigabytes left. So you may want to just like add an extra gigabyte to this number, just so it gives it a little bit more performance. And hopefully that should help you improve your performance. And then you just click save and that's it. Now, like I said, I didn't include the Minecraft physics mod because you have to pay for it. If you want to get the Minecraft physics mod, you go to minecraftphysicsmod.com. Here it is. And you can click download. You can pay for the pro version. There is a free version which has some of the stuff, so you can download that and install it in exactly the same way you would have installed the fresh animations. Just go back there and follow the same steps, but just put the physics mod in the mod folder for CurseForge or for doing it manually. And there's one extra thing that I want to talk about really quick, which is that I've made a Discord. So I know some of you have asked me to make a Discord, so I've made one. It's really basic at the moment, so I might actually just need your guys' help to make it into something better. But if you want to join it, the link is also in the description, and come and join. I'm going to be posting, you know, a bunch of stuff there when I go live, when I post the videos, all of that kind of stuff. I'm hoping to build it with you guys and we can make something really fun. But yeah, go ahead and join if you feel like it, and I'll see you guys in there. Apart from that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you found it helpful, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys. Bye. Bye-bye.